standing back there, someone said to me, "Where are all these people coming from? There's too many people in church." So I thought we should go through the sheepfold here and sort out the goats. The ones that shouldn't be here. You know, we just need to do a better screening program at the doors, don't you think? Because there's some people we don't want here. Come on, follow me. Now look at Bill. He is older than I am and he has a full head of hair. That's not fair. Out of here, I think. Let's see. Oh my gosh, Wayne is here. Ah, you know, did you show your ID when you came in?
I did.
You did? Okay, so you passed that screen. All right, he's okay.
I'm a good Catholic boy.
A good Catholic boy. I'm so glad to hear it. And a good husband, one I read on Facebook. Let's see, is it Colby and Jesse? You know, these people are too young to come to church. Look, would you all stand up, please? I asked them ahead of time. Look how young they are. They shouldn't be here. Oh, speaking of young, but that's okay, you came with your parents. They came without their parents. Gone. Oh my God, Mark. That's a whole other story. I think he's out of here. Clint, he does not agree with my political stance. Clint, you're out of here. You got too much hair on your head. Another priest in the church. There's not room for two priests. Out of here. Oh, and then there's Audrey. Audrey, who never expresses her opinion, out of here. What do you think? Will that work? Should we get rid of people?
No.
No?
No.
Why not? We invite everyone? You mean the Butler's family? Listen to that. Thank you. Good answer. I have a bumper sticker on my van, and I was in a parking lot, and this younger, not middle-aged, but not, whatever, came up and said, "I love your sticker," and it says, "God welcomes everybody, no exceptions." No exceptions. You mean I gotta let Bill stay here? I gotta let Wayne and Clint and Mark stay here? And these young people? Well, Jesus said a little child shall leave them, and they've said it, so we got to do it. We got to just welcome everybody. Okay. Now, there's no children's chapel today, so go back to your parents and listen to my whole sermon. Say, "Yes, sir." Okay. Okay, so as you listen to the readings, we're reading the story of Acts, the story of Philip going to this Ethiopian eunuch who works in the court, if you will, of the Queen of Ethiopia, which is not the Ethiopia of today. You would think that this would be about inclusion, and it is. But it's really about the disciples and apostles following Jesus' command, go from Jerusalem to Samaria, where Philip just came from, to the ends of the earth, and share the good news. And listen, as the Ethiopian is reading, he needs someone to interpret it for him. There might be people out in this community that need some interpreting done. That's our job. And then the letter of John, you know, I think he was part of that Jesus movement in the 60s. Love, love, love. We gotta love everybody. Okay, we're going on and on about this love thing. Yeah, I mean, we read it last week. What was wrong with that? But we'll read it again this week. Yes, love. And then Jesus, in the gospel, is talking about stay connected to me. Stay connected to the vine. I am am the way, the truth, and the life for my best friends. And my best friends need to stay connected to me. So listen to the word of the Lord.